हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम इन ई लर्निंग बाय से छोटेलाल एकेडमी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर मैथमेटिक्स क्लास फॉर क्लास 8 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू रीड आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज रेशनल नंबर्स। सो चिल्ड्रन, एज यू ऑलरेडी रेड इन योर प्रीवियस क्लासेस that what are rational numbers. So today again I am giving you the introduction of rational numbers, that rational numbers are those numbers that can be written in the form of p upon q, where q is never equals to 0. Q is never equals to 0, that means our denominator should never be 0. Suppose I am giving you an example. A number is given to you that 2 upon 5. 2 upon 5 is a rational number. So when we want to check, so we will have to see that p upon q, so p is equals to 2 and q is equals to 5. So we can say that 2 upon 5 is a rational number because q here is not equals to 0. So we can say that every natural number, suppose we have taken a natural number that is 5. 5 is a natural number. We can write 5 as 5 upon 1. So it is a rational number. We can take any other number, suppose a whole number that is 0. We can write 0 as 0 upon 1. So we can say that every whole number is a rational number. We can take integers also. Suppose we have taken minus 5. It is an integer. We can write minus 5 upon 1. That is equivalent to minus 5. So it is also a rational number. All these three are rational number because they are written in the form of p by q, where q is not equals to 0. Now our next topic is types of rational number. Rational number are of two types. The first one is positive rational numbers. Another one is negative rational numbers. So we can see that types of rational numbers. Rational numbers are of two types. First is positive rational numbers, another is negative rational numbers. In the positive rational numbers, all the positive integers are considered as 2 upon 3, 7 upon 9, 3 upon 5, 1 whole 1 upon 9, 6 upon 7. 2, 1. These are positive rational numbers. These are the examples of positive rational numbers. They are so many. It is not possible to show you all, but some examples we have taken here. Now, negative rational numbers. So, all the negative integers that we have taken earlier, minus 2 upon 5, minus 3 upon 2, minus 6 upon 7, minus 2 upon 7, minus 5 upon 9. All these are the examples of negative rational numbers. 0 is another integer that is neither negative nor positive. So 0 upon 1 is a rational number that can be considered as neither to be negative, neither to be positive. So 0 upon 1 is a rational number that is not included in positive, not included in negative. Next, we are going to read how to represent the rational numbers on the number line. So children, I have drawn here a number line, and I am going to represent a number that is 2 upon 3 on this number line. 2 upon 3 is a rational number, and we are going to represent this rational number on this number line. So exactly we need to check that which in between which two integers this rational number lies. We can see here that the whole number is missing in this part. So only 2 upon 3 is written here. That means this rational number should be there in between 0 and 1, because it is greater than 0 and less than 1. So we have drawn here 1. We have written here 1. So 0 to 1 is the space where somewhere 2 upon 3 should lie. Now we are going to draw where 2 upon 3 exactly lies. So now the work for the denominator. Denominator is 3. We can see that its denominator is 3. That means we will have to do the three parts of this space. And this is space. This space is given to us for three parts. And make sure that if you draw only two lines in this space, it will be divided in three parts. Just as I have drawn only two marks on this number line, and this space has been divided now in three equal parts. On the first part, we will write 1 upon 3, because all these parts are 1 upon 3. This part is 1 upon 3, this part is 1 upon 3, this part is 1 upon 3. So from 0 to the first mark, it will be 1 upon 3. From 0 to the second mark, it will be 2 upon 3. And from 0 to the third mark, that we have written 1 here already, it is 3 upon 3. And we all know that 3 upon 3 is just equal to 1. So we can see now the numerator is 2. That means the rational number should be present here. We can mark the place and write here 2 upon 3. Like this, we can show any of the rational number on the number line. Suppose we can take another example of negative rational number. I have taken minus 2 by 5. Now this rational number, I am going to show you here, its whole number is missing again. That means this number should be in between 0 and minus 1. So 0 and minus 1, this space should be divided into how many parts? 5 parts, because our denominator is 5 here. So we have to divide this space in 5 equal parts. So you may take the help of the skill by to do the equal parts. So 0 to minus 1, first line, second, third, fourth. If I have drawn 4 marks only, so these 4 marks will divide all this space in 5 equal parts. Now at the first part, we will write here minus 1 upon 5, at the second minus 2 upon 5, at the third minus 3 upon 5, at the fourth place minus 4 upon 5, and exactly that we have done to the right, we have also done to the left. Minus 1 is equivalent to minus 5 upon 5. Now we will see the numerator, that is 2. So we can check this place exactly denotes minus 2 upon 5. So we will mark a dark point here. And minus 2 upon 5, we will write here, this place exactly shows minus 2 upon 5. Children, if you have any query related to this video, you can ask me. This is my WhatsApp number. You can send me message. I will reply your queries. थैंक यू।